Hello students, today in this video we will see with the projectile motion given with angular projection. In the previous video I have told with the horizontal projection. So angular projection, now I am standing in a base of the ground, okay. You imagine like you standing in the base of the ground and you are throwing some object like ball or anything, okay. Now imagine as it is the ground surface, clear, and I am standing here and throwing a ball like this, okay. So the motion which I give is in this direction, upward direction, clear. So with the initial velocity u, initial velocity, clear. So this initial velocity is given by me while throwing the ball with the angular projection, means this is theta, with any angle I may project, clear. So when I throw a ball to the free space above the ground, it has two components. One is the horizontal component and the other one is the vertical component. So horizontal component u cos theta, vertical component u sin theta, clear. This u cos theta remains same all over the motion, but this u sin theta varies with respect to the height. Why? Because this u cos theta will not be affected by the acceleration due to gravity of the earth, but this u sin theta is affected by the acceleration due to gravity. Means when the motion is in the upward direction, the velocity u sin theta decreases, okay. So like this it goes same way, this is same, and this decreases, and at the final point only the horizontal component is present, clear. So if I complete the motion, it will be in this way, okay. So when this motion is completed, like this is the maximum point, okay. So as it reaches the height, the u sin theta decreases the value because it has to move against the acceleration due to gravity. And when it comes down, the same way the u cos theta remains the same, this increases slightly increases, okay, like this. It increases when it comes to the ground because it is under the action of the acceleration due to gravity, clear. Now in this scenario we are going to tell this it attains a parabola in the graph, okay. I have to draw the vertical component, no? Vertical, this is horizontal x, this is y, clear. U sin theta, this is u sin theta, clear. U sin theta, u cos theta for this angle, and this is the resultant, clear. The same way for everything it goes, clear children, okay. Now we will prove that this is the parabolic motion by finding the equation for trajectory, clear. Trajectory of the equation, we are going to find the trajectory of the equation. Suppose the body, thrown body, reaches the point P. The horizontal distance covered between this time period is u, let it be as x, okay. Horizontal distance be x, this is horizontal distance, clear. Then this horizontal distance is equated with the horizontal velocity and the time, means x is equated with horizontal velocity, clear, velocity and then time, okay. horizontal velocity, we will take it as u cos theta, correct? We know that horizontal velocity as u cos theta into time t. Then we will get t as x by u cos theta equals to t. Here we got the value for t. For vertical motion, now we have find for the horizontal motion. For vertical motion, u is u sin theta. Clear? Vertical motion. Vertical motion. Clear? U, we will take it as u sin theta. And a as minus g. This horizontal motion is not affected by the acceleration due to gravity, but this vertical motion is affected by the acceleration due to gravity. So we take it as minus g, because it goes against the gravity, upward motion. Clear? Then the vertical distance covered in time t is given by, we know the equation, s equals to ut plus half at square. By using this only, we are going to find the equation for trajectory. Y, let the vertical distance be y. Okay, so see here, let the vertical distance be y. Clear? Y means the distance is y. Then u sin theta. Clear? The vertical motion, we have taken the velocity as u sin theta. U sin theta, t, we find the value, x, u cos theta. However, the t will be the same irrespective of the vertical or horizontal motion. So, for simply, we can find the t value in the horizontal motion. So, we take the horizontal motion and found out the t value. And we substitute the t value over here. And u is u sin theta for the vertical motion. X plus half. No, this is the against gravity, so we will take it as minus g t square, x by u cos square theta, x square by u square cos square theta. We got it? Then u we can cancel it, and sin theta and cos theta is tan theta. So u x tan theta minus g by 2 u square cos square theta to x square. This is the trajectory. Clear? Trajectory of the motion. The angular projected motion. Clear? Now children, one thing I have to change it, okay, to get the parabolic path. Means we will take tan theta as t, okay, and this g by 2 u square cos square theta as p, q, okay, this will be as q, tan theta as p. Then if you substitute these values in the equation, x p minus q x square, q x square. Now you can easily say that y is a function of quadratic function of x is the y, correct? Thus y is a quadratic function of x, means this is a quadratic equation. So hence we can prove the trajectory of a projectile is a parabola. Clear? Next we will move on to the time of maximum height, time of flight, maximum height of the projectile, horizontal range, and the velocity of the projectile at any instant, two angles of projection for the same horizontal range, everything in the next video, children, because here time has been elapsed for the introductory part itself. Okay, if you like this video, subscribe our channel and view compulsorily the next video, children. That only is the completion of this angular projection. Clear? Bye bye, children.